Well, hello and welcome to another Faith, Philosophy and Life with me, Mr. Shelton. I do hope that you are doing well. We're in a series at the moment thinking about the Holocaust, and we last lesson thought about an introduction to the Holocaust. I want you to think, what do you remember about the Holocaust? What do you remember from last lesson about the bystander and the victim and the other people we thought about? What was the Holocaust? Have a think about that. Grab your pen and paper as well, because here's our cheesy intro sequence. So, our title today is How Did the Holocaust Develop? How did the Holocaust develop? Please make sure you get that written down and the date as well. So, our learning objective is to explore how the Holocaust was a series of events. It's going to be a good outcome if you can describe some of the events leading up to the Holocaust. Great if you can explain some of the key moments leading to the Holocaust, and even better if you can evaluate which events do you think caused the largest issues for the Jewish people and why. As always, do pause me as we go, and obviously please send all of your work to your teachers, because we like to see what's going on. So during today's session, we're going to think about what life was like for the Jews. We're going to look at diary entries. You're going to look at how Hitler came to power, so a little bit of history, but it does really tie in with what we're doing. Look at the timeline and then a newspaper headlines as well. And you can see above my head how this fits in with the skin work at the school that I'm at. And this unit fits in with a lot of things that you've done previously, and also looks forward as well to the human rights unit, which we will be doing next. So in this unit, we've got the introduction, which we did last time. We've got the timeline we're doing today. We're going to look at some case studies, some Jewish responses, and then a memorial as well. So what we're going to start with is I've got a couple of adverts from Save the Children that I just think are just phenomenal adverts for making you think. Now, I will warn you that if you are a refugee, this is something that may cause a trigger for you, because it is based on that premise. And if you have no idea what I'm talking about, then I think this is going to be quite an eye-opener as to why some people make the decisions they do. So what I'd like you to do is I would like you to create four diary accounts watching these clips. So you're going to watch these clips, and then I want you to think about these four things. So just a short paragraph. What was your life like at the beginning? Okay, so watch this and then do a little bit about what your life was like at the beginning. Then explain what your life was like when your country was taken over. Your third diary account is what was life like when you were escaping on the boat. And finally, what was life like when you are being interviewed at the end. So just maybe a sort of four little paragraphs of information that will be quite useful for you. A little bit of reflection really is what I'm after in this task, and a bit of sensitivity as well, because this is really tough. So let's watch this now.
Happy birthday to you.
Make a wish.
Granny.
Hello.
Hello.
Have you done your homework?
Adam.
For a general strike.
Ready or not?
Here it comes.
Island clashes with Britain.
Live ammunition against.
Deserve to get shot.
And I stay at
Mum.
Air strikes on rebel position.
We are going to stay.
Tony.
Go.
Daddy!
Happy birthday to you. Make a wish, darling.
On What Story Tonight, as the terrorist rebellion enters another year,
Country's just not safe anymore. We've got to leave.
Into the deep, dark.
The fighting's getting closer.
That's the hospital.
Camps have been raided.
Merry Christmas.
No, you need to go somewhere! Get out of
there! Get out of
there! How are we supposed to get from there to there?
Just take the things that you need.
See you there.
City under siege.
Checkpoint!
Can't stop the bleeding!
You've only got enough for one.
Oh my god, no!
I will find you. You'll ring me when you get there.
I'm not getting on the boat without you!
Are you related?
No.
I mean,
thank you.
We found a family for Alfie.
He's all I've got left. 60th of May, 2003.
It's today, happy birthday. Hope you made a wish. And what are your parents' names? Lily, I know this is hard. Can you tell me your parents' names? Lily?
So, now you've seen those clips, let's get on with that task. Unpause me, or pause me now, and then come back to me when you're done. Okay, so we said a good outcome would be to describe some of the events leading up to the Holocaust. Now, right now, we haven't really touched that. But what we have done is started to think about what life is like for people who have their countries taken over in a very disturbing way. That's exactly what happened to the Jews, apart from it was even more subversive because Hitler rose to power. So talking about that, how did Hitler rise to power? Let's just watch this to give you some context.
In September 1919, a former amateur artist and army veteran named Adolf Hitler joined the ranks of the German Workers' Party, later known as the Nazis. It was a decision that would have a profound impact not only on Germany, but the entire world. The atrocities committed by the Nazis at the height of their power are staples of every lesson on World War II. But just how did a democracy like Germany fall under the sway of a tyrant in the first place? It all goes back to Germany's loss to the Allies in World War I. German leaders were forced to sign the Treaty of Versailles, agreeing to shrink its armed forces, give up land, and pay large sums of money in reparations, weakening its already unstable economy. Many Germans felt humiliated and betrayed by their leadership, and there was growing fear that their nation would be stuck in poverty and decline. In this climate of bitterness, Hitler rose to prominence. A gifted public speaker, he captured the people's disillusionment with a series of speeches calling for a stronger, unified Germany. He insisted that one group was to blame for the nation's post-war misfortunes. The Jews. Hitler and his followers attempted a government coup in 1923, but the plan failed. Hitler was jailed for treason for 9 months, but the publicity from the failed coup made him more popular than ever. Then, in 1929, the Great Depression hit, destroying the German economy overnight and leaving millions unemployed. Hitler saw the ensuing chaos as his opportunity to seize power. He loudly criticized the ruling government and promised to return Germany to greatness. Long-suffering Germans believed they had finally found their savior. In Germany's 1932 elections, the Nazis won a majority of seats in parliament, and Hitler ran for president. Though he lost, his soaring popularity inspired President Paul von Hindenburg to appoint him chancellor, the head of the German government. As chancellor, Hitler wasted no time tightening his grip on every aspect of German life. He tripled the size of the military, violating the Treaty of Versailles. Under Hitler's orders, rival parties were banned, while paramilitary groups cracked down on protests and executed political opponents. Anti-Semitic laws prohibited Jews from working, voting, and occupying public spaces. A propaganda department produced art, films, and books praising Hitler and embracing his vision of a better Germany. After the death of President von Hindenburg in 1934, Hitler declared himself Führer, an absolute dictator. With Germany under his total control, Hitler would shift his focus to global domination, setting the stage for World War II.
Okay, so the next task then that I need you to do, I know it says using the information around the room, and I appreciate if you're at home, you're probably not going to print it all off and stick it around your room. What I'd like you to do is I'd like you to access in the description below the timeline that looks something like that there. And also you'll find a series of information as well. And what your task is to create a timeline about what led up to the Holocaust. And I think that would be a really useful task for you to do. This is going to take you probably about 15, 20 minutes to do. So you'll need to pause me, access the description below, as I say, and come back to me when you are done. See you in a few. Okay, so with that done, these then are the I thought they were the answers, but obviously not. But our short thought then is, which event do you think out of all of these had the biggest effect on Jewish people and why? Which event had the biggest effect on Jewish people and why? So do that now. You'll have to pause me and come back to me when you are done. Okay, so what you're going to do now is our newspaper headline task. You can see some of the newspapers that were published at the time. If I just move my head out the way. So you're going to create a series of newspaper headlines from 1933 to 1945. And then what you're going to do is choose one of those newspaper headlines and write a little bit more about it. Now you can see some examples there. Where I've got a headline at the top, eyes wide open, eyes wide with terror as death counts open. And then underneath I've got a short paragraph where I explain that a little bit more. Okay, so your task then is to create a series of newspaper headlines based on the events that you can see in that headline there. And then, so you'll have a series of headlines and then you're going to really drill into one of those with a short paragraph. So, pause me now, do that, give yourself a couple of minutes before you come back to me at the end. So, a good outcome would be describe some of the events leading up to the Holocaust. Hopefully you've got that sorted now. Great if you talk about some key moments leading up to that, and even better if you could talk about which events caused the largest issues for the Jewish people. Obviously that's your opinion there. So, I appreciate that you're probably not doing this in a classroom, but maybe send a photograph of your work to a friend if you know somebody else that's off, critique theirs, let them look at yours, share some ideas and see how you could best improve your work. So I'm going to leave that there for the day. Thanks for your time. Take care of yourself. Stay safe. Wash hands. God bless you. And I'll be seeing you soon.